be with you. Welcome to Faith Lutheran Church on the seventh Sunday after the Pentecost. Thank you all for the prayers and concerns of Sabrina's and I travels. It was beautiful and everybody is safe. It's always good to see the grandkids and your kids, your son-in-law. And one thing I found out when I was there, one of my daughter's friends asked, she said, "Asia, can your dad pray for me?" And Asia said, "Girl, he prays for the whole city of Indianapolis." And so in our readings today, it talks about the sower of the seeds. And our job is to continue to sow the seeds. And I was so glad to see that every Sunday I would send my family, my daughter, my son, our church service. And you don't really think they're looking. She was looking and she was listening. And she thanked the church and she thanked us for praying for her. And she received it joyfully. And she told her friends that prayer really works. She said, "My parents pray for me all the time." And so continue to sow the seeds. And the seed is the word of God. And that's going to be our focus today, is continually to sow the seeds. And understand that we all have four types of soil in us. Sometimes we are rocky, sometimes we're hard, sometimes we're thorny, and sometimes we are good. We are all those at one point and time in our life. So I want us to remember, be the good soil. Receive the word of God. Take root in the tree of life and understand that the Lord is with us. And in our readings today, it says, when we suffer, it says, Jesus says, "Take me with you." He says, "Take me with you and suffer with me, and you will be exalted with me." Those are the words of Jesus Christ, and those are the seeds that we need to continue to sow. Amen. Follow us on YouTube at Faith Inglewood 3320. Check out our webpage at faithing.org. As we gather, though you may be familiar with Jesus' parable of the sower, you may be surprised to hear what you do not really know it yet. That is because on the one hand, the word of God does not change. Yet on the other hand, we need to keep hearing it again and again, because our circumstances are constantly changing. The parable of the sower tells of this mystery. The seed is God's word, God's work of planting repentance and faith in ears who hear. We may think of the various kinds of soil Jesus mentions to be various sorts of people. Actually, however, he is describing each individual in their changing circumstances. There are times when we are the good soil. That is, when we understand God's word and we take comfort in his word. There are other times, however, when we either cannot or will not hear it. Sometimes we become hard paths. We become rocky or distracted by worries and by fears. And it is for this reason that God never ceases planting, speaking, and growing faith in the heart. And we return repeatedly to continue to hear, continue to read, continue to learn, and to continue to receive God's word, because God never gives up on us. God will never give up on any one of you. When you suffer, take Jesus with you. Call to worship.
Thank you.
today and bright hope for tomorrow. Blessings all mine with 10,000 beside. Great is thy faithfulness, great is thy faithfulness. Morning by morning, new mercies I see. All I have needed, thy hand hath provided. Great is thy faithfulness, Lord, unto me. Wild grapes, according to Isaiah, means that the people of God were following no leadership, but their own will and their own conscience. God wants us to be cultivated grapes, guided by the word and tended by the spirit, wherever we live and wherever we work. While we are thankful for the church buildings, for the beauty and utility of these structures, it is the people and how they live in the world that are the church at work. Amen. Please rise. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. For we ourselves were once foolish, disobedient, led astray, slaves to various passions and pleasures. But when the goodness and loving kindness of God our Savior appeared, by the washing of regeneration and renewal of the Holy Spirit, so that being justified by His grace, join in our opening hymn, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee. Call us to rejoice in thee.
Thou art giving and forgiving, ever blessed. How to love each other, lift us to the joy divine. Angels join the mighty which the morning stars began. Father, love is reigning o'er us. Brother, love binds man to man. Ever singing, march we onward, victors in the midst of strife. Joyful music lifts us onward in the triumph song of life.
Amen. You may be seated. In that divine hope, let us confess our sins to God our Father. Fruitful trees, the Spirit sowing. Upon this your confession, I, by virtue of my office as a called and ordained servant of the word, announce the grace of God to you all. And in the stead and by the command of my Lord Jesus Christ, I forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. The Lord is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, and abounding in steadfast love. As for man, his days are like grass. He flourishes like a flower of the field, for the wind passes over it, and it is gone, and its place knows it no more. But the steadfast love of the Lord is from everlasting to everlasting on those who fear him, and his righteousness to children's children, to those who keep his covenant and to remember to do his commandments. The Lord has established his throne in heaven, and his kingdom rules over all. In peace, let us pray in the fellowship of the Spirit. For the peace from above and for our salvation, let us pray for the blessing of the Spirit. For the peace of the whole world, for the well-being of the Church of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray as we are united by the Spirit. For this holy house, and for all who offer here their worship and praise, let us pray as we rejoice in the Spirit. Help, save, comfort, and defend us, O Holy Spirit, for you live and reign with the Father and the Son, one God, now and forever. Please join the hymn of praise.
my rock. He's my fortress. He's my deliverer. In him will I trust. Praise the name of Jesus.
The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Blessed Lord, since you have caused all holy scriptures to be written for our learning, grant that we may so hear them, read, mark, learn, and inwardly digest them, that we may embrace and ever hold fast to the blessed hope of everlasting life through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. May the God of peace and joy fill you all with hope and love. Peace be with you. Greet everyone with the wave of peace. Peace of the Lord be with you. In our ministry today, I want to talk about suffering and suffering with the Lord. And there's a litany in our African American heritage hymnal, and I'm just going to read a couple of the scriptures and words of our Lord that support our Father in heaven when he sent us a Savior. Give ear to my prayer, O God. Do not hide yourself from my supplication. Attend to me and answer me. I am troubled in my complaint. I am distraught. Fear and trembling have come upon me, and horror overwhelms me. And I say, oh, that I had wings like a dove. I would fly away, and I would be at rest. Truly, I would flee far away. I would lodge in the wilderness. I would hurry to find shelter for myself from the raging wind and the tempest. But I call upon God, and the Lord will save me. Cast your burden on the Lord, and he will sustain you. He will never permit the righteous to be moved. Amen. Let us remember that we are a called people. We are a royal priesthood. We are righteous not by what we do, but what Jesus does for us. We are made righteous in him. Today we're going to talk about the soil. Good soil. We're going to talk about bad soil. We're going to talk about how do we be at peace among the weeds, the harvest, when it grows, the weeds and the good plants, they look alike until they're exalted by our Heavenly Father. Our growth depends on our hearts. This is the season of Pentecost. The Holy Spirit will rain down upon you, and he will give you a clean heart so that we can serve the Lord, so that we can serve him gladly. But we're going to suffer. Don't suffer alone, no matter who you are. You are not alone. You have your family. You have your outside family. But you have the triune God that will get you through anything. Amen. Call to prayer. Dear Lord, we praise you, O God. We acknowledge you to be our Lord. All the earth worships you, our Creator and our Redeemer. By your mighty word, all things live and move and have their being. We praise you for your creation. But with even greater praise, we give thanks for your recreating word by which you have conquered sin and conquered death, and restoring earth's beauty and eternal life to all who believe. Because your word is strong, Lord. Cause your word to be received and believed by all the people, giving everyone your new life through faith in your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Lord, in your mercy, for the glorious company of the apostles, the fellowship of the prophets, and the evangelists of your gospel, we give you thanks, Lord. Give conviction and strength to all today who you have called and ordained to proclaim your word to this generation and bring forth the fruits of faith and love in all those renewed by your word and by the Spirit. Lord, in your mercy, God bless our native land with freedom and wisdom to acknowledge your holy word, as the only sure foundation of governments is in line with your grace and your wisdom and your will. Raise up servants to guard, guide, and to protect all citizens of our country in the way of your truth. Lord, in your mercy, as you promise your own healing and peace and comfort for all your people, so surround all who suffer in any need, any sickness, and any adversity. And Lord, we pray this day for Faith Lutheran Church and for Marcia and Zoe and for Betty and Desmond. We pray for Burl Taylor. Pray for Shayla and Larita. Pray for Lucia. Pray for Ava, Simone Angulo, and Kimberly Angulo, and Deborah Arnold, and Joseph Arnold. Lord, thank you for our brother, Freddie Baker, making contact with one another. God bless you, Freddie. Lord, be with our brother, Kurt Gottbauer, as his church put on a very nice festival yesterday. God bless him and the ministry at Christ Concordia, Lord, in LA. We pray for Gwendolyn Bob, Tony Broughton, Sylvia Broughton. It's good to see our sister Carol Brown yesterday also. Pray for Kim Brown and Rodney Brown. Pray for Weldon Carey Sr. and his lady Tina. We pray for Adrian Carrington and her family. Lord, thank you for blessing us with our sister Mimi Carmichael this morning. Good to see you, Mimi. Zelda Carter, Derek Chandler, June Chandler Enoch, London Riley Chandler, Troy and Sabrina Clements, Sharon Collins and her sister Carol, Odessa Cox, Mike Cox, William Crawford, Leslie Davis, Claire DeCure, Grant and Terry Doster, Vermel. God be with Reggie and Marilyn as they travel inland to the heat. Pray for Elena, Ariona. Pray for my mom, Ruby Foster, my wife, Sabrina Foster, my son, Anthony Foster Jr. Lord, we pray for Udolpho Fulton. Continue to heal that brother. Pray for Patsy and Stephen and Leslie and John Green, Bishop Cleophas and First Lady Stephanie. Pray for Elaine Griffin and Sean Heads, Simone Heads. Lord, continue to strengthen Stephanie and Donald on the path to recovery.
Thank you for all the work Gail and Lamont Houston do. Lamont Houston Sr., pray for Keish, continue to heal her, Lord. Pray for Taylor and Zenora and Tashana, Irby, Carl Jackson Jr. Pray for Daria and Colleen and the Perkins and the city of Indianapolis. Pray for Eula May, Kurt. Pray for Randy and Rayner. Pray for Douglas Jordan, Kathy Keith, Kevin Keith, and Stanley Keith. Pray for my neighbor, Emma Key. Continue to strengthen her, Lord. Pray for Regenia Jemison, Dana Johnson, and Gay Sandra Kimball, Otis Knighton, Royden Knighton, Kevin Knighton, Sherry Harper Knighton, Audrey Lehman. Lord, continue to be with our sister Lillian. Lillian, we miss you, and God's peace be with you and your family. We pray for Rhea and Dimitri. Pray for Clarine Long. Lord, continue to be the beacon of light in our brother Von Sells Lewis Light. Lord, continue to lead him on the paths of righteousness for your name's sake. Pray for Daniel Mills Sr., Darlene and Davine, Jalen and Vicky. Pray for Regina Morris. Continue to strengthen our sister Val Murphy, Lord. God bless you. Aubrey Oton, be my neighbor Celestine Parks. Continue to comfort her, give her strength as she struggles with her breathing, Lord. Pray for Ashley Parker, Stephanie Parker, Karen Parker, and Joseph Parker. Pray for our cousin Wendy Parker, business partner Ed Perez, Yvonne Pitts. Pray for Bobby Relaford, Crystal Relaford, and Brian Relaford Jr. Lord, thank you for blessing us to see Asia and Manny and Lux and Rico and spend time and be safe on our holiday travels. Be with William Rhodes Sr. and Debbie Rhodes, Honey Robinson, Nyla Gross Rees, my aunt Vera Russell. Be with Pastor and Linda Sleaf. Lord, bring comfort to our sister, Gwen Simmons. It was good to talk to you this week, Gwen, and we pray for comfort and less pain in your knees and in your joints. We pray for Ethel Souls, Haram Souls, and Sheila Souls. Continue to strengthen our sister, Dion Smith. Pray for Margaret Talbert, and pray for our beloved Effie Thompson, and thank you for volunteering in the office, Effie. Thank all our volunteers. Pray for Peter Todd, Robert Terrell, Gloria Truitt, Taylor Turner, Nikki Vaden. Lord, bless Nikki and her ministries. Give her guidance and let her know that if she leans on you, it'll be okay. Pray for Marie Washington. Pray for Chris White, Elijah White, Ethan White. Lord, our sister Ruth, she has a fracture in her wrist, Lord. So bring comfort to her. She says she'll be out a few weeks, and Lord, just give her strength to persevere. Give strength to her son, Theron, also. We pray for Naya Wilson and Mike Wilson and Jabari Wilson and Damani Wilson. We pray for Michael and Tama Williams Villasenor and Michael Zenon in the Senior Housing Project. Lord, be with those who are hospitalized, those who are shut in, those who need caregivers. We pray for Cassandra Harris on her recovery, Yazid Boss as he recovers. We pray for those in convalescent and assisted living facilities. Have mercy upon them and lead them on the path to health according to your will. Lord, we pray for the birthdays of Deacon Reggie Fields and Christina Thompson and Gloria Truitt. And we pray for all who are celebrating anniversaries, and we pray for the 65th anniversary of Faith Lutheran Church. We pray for the shared ministries here on our campus, New Salvation Ministries and Pastor Gerald Fortier. Lord, be with all who travel, Brother Mike Wilson, Marilyn, and Reggie Fields as they travel, and all who travel, Lord, keep them safe and under your light. We pray for leadership, for those who work to bring peace, justice, and health and protection in this and every place. We pray for the LWML and the VEMT. We pray for our government officials, our military, our law enforcement, our college students, our high school students, our middle school students, our elementary school students. Pray for our preschoolers. And we pray for those in children's daycare and adult daycare. As we bereave the loss of our loved ones, we pray for families of police brutalities, and we pray for families of family brutality. We pray for our brothers and sisters in Ukraine. Lord, bring peace to the region. Grant that their faith never fail and that their prayers never cease. Lord, in your mercy, as the washing of the water with your word and holy baptism raises us to new life now by faith, give the confidence of resurrection to eternal life to all. We give thanks for all who have departed in faith and who now rest from their labors. Keep us in wisdom and confidence of the faith in the word of our Lord Jesus Christ, who said, "Everyone who lives and believes in me shall never die." Lord, in your mercy, into your hands, O Lord, we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your mercy through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Let the people say amen. We now have the opportunity to bless the Lord with our tithes and with our offerings. Please rise. Father in heaven, when we consider the gift of your only Son, we're self-conscious of the meager gifts that we bring. Therefore, we pray for a stronger faith to give of ourselves and our possessions more generously to those in need and to support the resurrection ministry through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. You may be seated. We continue with the reading of the Word of God.
May the peace of the Lord be with you. The Old Testament reading is recorded in Isaiah chapter 55, verses 10 through 13. God's powerful word for all. For as the rain and the snow come down from heaven and do not return there, but water the earth, making it bring forth and sprout, giving seed to the sower and bread to the eater, So shall my word be that goes out from my mouth. It shall not return to me empty, but it shall accomplish that which I purpose, and shall succeed in the thing for which I sent it. For you shall go out in joy and be led forth in peace. The mountains and the hills before you shall break forth into singing, and all the trees of the field shall clap their hands. Instead of the thorn shall come up the cypress. Instead of the briar shall come up the myrtle. And it shall make a name for the Lord, an everlasting sign that shall not be cut off. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Our psalm of the day. By awesome deeds you answer us with righteousness. O God of our salvation, praise is due to you, O God in Zion, and to you shall vows be performed.
O you who hear prayer, to you shall all flesh come.
When iniquities prevail against me, you atone for my transgressions.
Blessed is the one you choose to bring near to dwell in your courts.
We shall be satisfied with the goodness of your house, the holiness of your temple.
By awesome deeds you answer us with righteousness, O God of our salvation, the hope of all the ends of the earth and of the farthest seas.
The one who is by his strength established the mountains, being girded with might.
Who stills the roaring of the sea, the roaring of
so that those who dwell at the ends of the earth are in awe at your signs. You make the going out of the morning and the evening to shout for joy.
By awesome deeds you answer us with righteousness, O God of our salvation, the hope of all the ends of the earth and all the farthest seas.
Music ministry.
May the peace of the Lord be with you. The epistle is recorded in Romans chapter 8, verses 12 through 17. Life through the Spirit. So then, brothers, we are debtors, and not to the flesh, to live according to the flesh. For if you live according to the flesh, you will die. But if by the Spirit you put to death the deeds of the body, you will live. For all who are led by the Spirit of God are sons of God. For you did not receive the spirit of slavery to fall back into fear, but you have received the spirit of adoption as sons, by whom we cry, Abba, Father. The Spirit himself bears witness with our spirit that we are children of God, and if children, then heirs, heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ, provided we suffer with him in order that we may also be glorified with him. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
I hold a little door, nothing left, and Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest friend, but only me, on Jesus' name. On Christ, a solid rock I stand. Holy Gospel according to St. Matthew, the 13th chapter. That same day, Jesus went out of the house and sat beside the sea, and great crowds gathered about him, so that he got into a boat and sat down. And the whole crowd stood on the beach, and he told them many things in parables, saying, a sower went out to sow, and he sowed some seeds. Some seeds fell along the path, and the birds came and devoured them. Other seeds fell on rocky ground, where they did not have much soil, and immediately they sprang up, but since they had no depth of soil. But when the sun rose, they were scorched, and since they had no root, they withered away. Other seeds fell among thorns, and the thorns grew up and choked them. Other seeds fell on good soil and produced grain, some 100-fold, some 60, and some 30. He who has ears, let him hear. Hear then the parable of the sower. When anyone hears the word of the kingdom and does not understand it, the evil one comes and snatches away what has been sown in his heart. This is what was sown along the path. As for what was sown on rocky ground, this is the one who hears the word and immediately receives it with joy. Yet it has no root in himself, but endures for a while. When tribulation or persecution arises on account of the word, he immediately falls away. As for the one sown among thorns, this is the one who hears the word, but the cares of the world and the deceitfulness of riches choke the word and proves unfruitful. As for what was sown on good soil, this is the one who hears the word and understands the word. He indeed bears fruit and yields in one case 100-fold, in another 60, and in another 30. This is the gospel of the Lord. Hymn of the day, come ye thankful people, come. You may be seated. Come ye thankful people, come. Praise the song of harvest home. Thank you. Amen. Grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and from our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Amen. What kind of soil is your life? What kind of soil is my life? Are we hard? Are we rocky? Are we thorny? Or are we good? At one time or another, we've been all four of those. The parable today makes us ask ourselves those questions about the topic of soil, bad soil that is choked out by stones and thorns, and where the seeds go, but nothing changes. But then we have the good soil, where the seed of God's word can put down roots, where it can grow, where it can mature, and where it can bear fruit. What is happening with the seed of God's word in your life? We come to church every Sunday. We read the scriptures. We hear the scriptures. We go to Bible study on Wednesdays. We go to Bible studies on Sundays. Is the word of God sinking in your life? As we listen to God's word, as we attempt to understand God's word, God wants us to bear fruit. He wants our life to be rooted and sustained in his word to produce fruit. Many times, our sinful hearts are just unready to believe God's word. Many times we're not ready to bear fruit, but Christ never stops sowing his gospel upon us. He knows one day it'll be a miracle on that day and you will bear fruit. I look at my journey in the ministry. They kept throwing the seeds of the word at me. It bounced off for years. It would come, it would germinate. In any adversity, it would blow over and I would have to start all over again. Then one day, it took root. And when the word takes root, your biggest challenge is not to doubt it, even when you do not understand it. When it's not our call, it's God's will. How many of us willingly or readily recognize the bad soil profiles that Jesus describes in the parable today? How many of us can apply that to our own lives? There's the rocky path, the hard path, and we've even had hardcore paths where the seed is thrown at us and it just bounces off of us. And Jesus says, this is what happens when we do not understand God's word. Sometimes we just don't get it. We hear the gospel, we see the grace, but it makes very little impression on us. Why? Why are we so slow to receive God's word? There's the stony ground. You receive the word. You hear it. It begins to germinate. It begins to grow. We understand. We grasp hold of it. And we love the gospel message of forgiveness. And then we become so joyful, we forget where the joy came from. And we don't take root and we fall away. and die. Take root in the heart. Take root in the conscience. Take root in your self-worth. Being a follower of Jesus Christ is difficult. When our faith meets a challenge, our roots, if they're shallow, they will dry up, they will wither. And then we turn to something else for the solution. So what kind of soil are you? Hard, rocky, thorny, or good? Our worries in this life. We worry about our property, our goods, our possessions. We worry about our earthly security, and we worry about our earthly insecurity. We go through moments of self-doubt when we lack confidence. And then all these things begin to crowd in. They begin to choke out the word. When the word becomes choked out, we become fruitless once again. The seed is the word of God. Jesus' word in this parable are so telling. They tell us of our own spiritual climate, of who we are. Little or no rain. Are we too dry? Are we too hard? Are we too pig-headed to support growth and vegetation? The word of God shows us our spiritual hardness and our slowness to hear. Let us not fool ourselves. Many times we're stony, we're thorn infested. We let all the issues of the world drown out the word, and it withers up and it dies. But we have Christ, the sower of the word of God. Let us look at the sower and his work. He seemingly knows where to throw the seed. And guess where he throws the most seed? Into the most dehydrated, into the most unfruitful, into the most unproductive corners of the field. Only perhaps a quarter of the field will even grasp the seed. But that's what the word of God does. He throws it to all the people. About a quarter of us will receive it well. Jesus Christ, he holds back nothing. He spreads his seeds generously to all people, to all nations. Many people, and we know them, who ignore the message of the gospel. We know so many people who reject the word of God, and we see their lives where no seeds can grow, where no fruits can bear. Even we, his own people, we're inconsistent. We fall off. The seeds fall at our feet, and we don't receive them. But Christ, he died for all people. He died for even the people who rejected him. All the sins of the world have been forgiven. Heaven is open to all believers. Therefore, the sower still sows the gospel. We still sow the seed of God's word. We, the church, sow seeds to the world, no matter how good they are. No matter how bad they are, no matter how ugly their behavior is, our job is to continue to shower them with the word of God. The seed is God's word. The miracles that God performs for us, despite all the stones, all the thorns, all the hardness of our human hearts, some of this seed still lands on good soil and it grows. But it grows not sparsely, he says, but 30, 60, and 100-fold. If
if you let the word take hold in your life, me and you, even us with our rocky, with our weed-infested hearts, the sower knows where the seeds land. He knows you. He knows me. He keeps throwing seeds at us. On our day of baptism into Jesus' death, he, the sower, in his grace and in his mercy, he sowed the seed. He sowed it down into our hearts, and it has grown, and it has produced a faith of love in you and in me. Day by day, Sunday by Sunday, the same life-giving seed is sown into our lives. It is sown into our lives and in our hearts through our word and through our sacrament. That is the words of forgiveness and the gift of salvation. That is the gospel of Jesus Christ. That is the seed that we are to continue to sow. If we have any doubts about the power of the Lord, pay attention to what is happening in this, the divine service. The absolution is pronounced to you as you receive the Lord's Supper. The sower is sowing his seed in you, in me, in all of us. And look around in our Christian fellowship. Look at our neighbors. Look at our friends. Do not be hesitant to spread the seeds amongst your people. I said earlier, they threw so many seeds at me, I just stopped and received them all. I said, okay, I get it. Quit running from the Lord with your problems. The church for all its soil problems, is the life fruit-bearing work of Christ and his word. And in the season of Pentecost, it is the power of the Holy Spirit that will germinate the seed in you. The seed is the word of God, sown all around our church, all around our communities, all around the world. And all we are waiting for it to do is produce a hundredfold. Receive the gospel. Believe in your forgiveness. Believe that through the cross and the words, your life can be saved. The seed will grow in you. The seed is the word of God. Trust the word. Even when it seems to fail, it still produces God's harvest. That's where our confusion is. We want the production to be what we want. It's going to be what God wants for you. He knew you before you was in the womb. He knows the hairs on your head. He knows where you're headed. He said, let me help you. He said, let me germinate my seed in you. The sower knows his work. God is doing these things. God is doing things you don't even know about. Even though your lies and the lies of others, God is behind the scenes preparing us to bear fruit. Speak the word, trust the word, but continue to spread the word. This is so that we can speak the word clearly to others. By these blessings, this is the great assurance that we get. It is the encouragement that God gives us. He gives it to me. He gives it to you. He gives it to his disciples. He gives us the strength to be great farmers and just sow the seeds of the word to all people. Christ himself, he says, I throw it in all the places. Some of it is not going to catch hold. But when it does, we get to produce a multitude of fruit in his name. And it is for his sakes, for all of us as parents, as friends, as workers, as citizens. The seed is the word of God. Let us continue to sow the seeds. Amen. May the peace of God, which surpasses all of our human understanding, let it continue to guard our hearts and guard our minds in Christ everlasting. Amen.
there to my heart in the blood applied. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. From sin, Jesus so sweetly abides within. There at the cross where he took me in, glory to his name. Glory to his name. I am so glad I have entered in. There Jesus saves me and keeps me clean. Glory to his name. Glory to glory to his rise. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly good, right, and salutary that we should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, Holy Lord, Almighty Father, everlasting God. And most especially are we bound to praise you on this day for the glorious resurrection of your Son, Jesus Christ, the very Paschal Lamb, who was sacrificed for us and bore the sins of the world. By his dying, he has destroyed death, and by his rising again, he has restored to us everlasting life. Therefore, with Mary Magdalene, Peter and John, and with all the witnesses of the resurrection, and with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and saying, Amen. Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth, for you have had mercy on those whom you created, and sent your only begotten Son into our flesh to bear our sin and be our Savior. With repentant joy, we receive the salvation accomplished for us by the all-availing sacrifice of his body and his blood on the cross. Gathered in the name and the remembrance of Jesus, we beg you, O Lord, to forgive, renew, and strengthen us with your word and spirit. Grant us faithfully to eat his body and drink his blood, as he bids us do in his own testament. Gather us together, we pray, from the ends of the earth, to celebrate with all the faithful the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which has no end. Graciously receive our prayers, deliver and preserve us. To you alone, O Father, be all glory, honor, worship with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Please prepare your communion cups. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. And when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." Take and eat the body of Jesus given for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. In the same way also, he took the cup after supper. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is a new testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." Take and drink the blood of Jesus, shed for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. As often as we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim the Lord's death until he comes. O Lord Jesus Christ, only Son of the Father, and given us your body and blood to eat and to drink, you lead us to remember and confess your holy cross and passion, your blessed death, your rest in the tomb, your resurrection from the dead, your ascension into heaven, and your coming for the final judgment. So remember us in your kingdom, Lord, and teach us to pray. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Lamb. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Through this eating and drinking, may you be strengthened in your Christian faith and life. Go into the world with peace and joy, with the full forgiveness of all your sins. Depart in peace. Let us pray. Gracious God, our Heavenly Father, you have given us a foretaste of the feast to come in the Holy Supper of your Son's body and blood. Keep us firm in the true faith throughout our days of pilgrimage, that on the day of his coming, we may, together with all your saints, celebrate the marriage feast of the Lamb in his kingdom, which, Lord, has no end. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. The Lord make his face shine down upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and the Lord give you peace. Amen. Closing hymn, I love your kingdom, Lord. You may be seated.